Hello, God bless you. I pray that all is well. I am excited. I'm excited about tonight. I'm excited about all of the wonderful things that are going on. We got Florence headed our way, and many things are going on in the world. But I want to tell you that the God of the Bible is in control, and our faith and our confidence is in Him. Now, we are having service tonight at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ, and we're going to pray. We're going to pray that the God of the Bible would control the storm as He always does. We're praying for those who are in the direct path of the storm. You know, my friends, preparations are being made on this end. I've been in touch with World Vision. I've been in touch with the presiding bishop of the Church of God in Christ. I've been in touch with people, and plans are being made already to bring in truckloads and different things to help those who are directly affected by the storm. So we're praying and we're working. But let me tell you, God is good and He's merciful. Do you not know that from 2007 to the current time, only four named storms have made it to landfall? And they are Felix, Matthew, Irma, Maria, and if Florence, and so we got Florence coming, so I guess that will be the fifth one. But isn't it amazing, from 2007 up until now, only four. God is good and worthy to be praised. He's merciful to us. And isn't it amazing that when the storm comes, notice all of the news. I mean, you can't turn your television on for it. And we're talking about it, and people are afraid and all the things that go on. But when God gives us good weather, when the Lord smiles on us and He blesses us, and things are going the way we want, we don't give Him half the praise as you hear the complaints when things go wrong. These prognosticators come out, and these overnight theologians, they come out and say, well, how can a loving God let something happen like this? My friends, my position is, as sinful as mankind is, and as much as we ignore God, the Lord would be well within His rights if He allowed a Florence to come every day. If we had a Florence and a Felix, a Maria, a Irma, and a Matthew all at the same time. But look at how good and how merciful He is to us. And I'll tell you, Florence and all of the rest of them, those that make landfall and those that do not, are accomplishing God's purposes. And let me tell you something, my friends, just because you don't know what the purpose of God is, just because you don't know God's reasons behind allowing things to happen, doesn't mean that there's no purpose. It doesn't mean that there's no reason. So I tell you, we're going to keep our hands in the hand of the God of the Bible. We're going to come out tonight. Yes, we're having service tonight. You know, in case you've forgotten, we're holiness. And holiness churches are the last among the churches to cancel service. You know, during the winter, I'm always moved at how churches begin to cancel service 5 days out, 3 days out. The storm is coming. Snow is coming. Let's cancel already. And we don't even give God time to act. We don't even give God time to move. And I wonder today, whatever happened to the phrase, press your way. And when I first got saved back in 1977, and we were going to church, sometimes we had a ride, sometimes we didn't. Sometimes mom was going and I could catch a ride with her when I was there. And sometimes when mom was staying home, I had to use old Pat and Charlie. I remember walking to church and got a ride, but I wanted to be in the house of the Lord. Now listen, if by the time this airs and the weather tonight is inclement and you can't get out and it looks like, you know, it's dangerous, use your best judgment and stay home. But based on the way things look right now, I don't think Florence is going to stop us. As a matter of fact, we're going to come out and we're going to pray that God turn Florence. We're going to pray for those who are directly in the direct path of Florence. And we're going to continue to work with those who are making preparations to come to the rescue of those who have suffered losses. Our concern is for the most vulnerable, and we're going to believe God. So I'll see you tonight. There is a word from the Lord for you here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ.